Hello everyone, myself Maruti, welcome you all to this math video session. So in this video I'm going to deal with the quadratic equation under one variable, right? The only thing which messes up is nothing but predicting whether it is a linear equation under two variables or quadratic equation under one variable. What matters? What makes the difference? How to get it out from the question, which one is what? I can help you out regarding that. So to make you better understand that one, let me deal with the question for you. Here it says, the area of a rectangular plot is 528 square meters, right? He has taken a geometrical shape and the shape is nothing but a rectangle, and he's talking about the area. You know, area is nothing but the space in the rectangular piece, the space inside, right? The area of a rectangle is 528 square meters. Okay, fine. He has given one relation, and the word what he has used is area. He is talking about the geometrical figure, he has given the value, and the concept he is discussing is area. Area is one of the relation he has given. Keep it aside. One. The next one, the length of the plot is one more than its breadth. The length of the plot is one more than its breadth, right? So of course, find the length and breadth of the plot. Find the length and the breadth of the plot. So what he has given, what are the two relations he has given, and what he is asking, right? To make you better understand, let's go for a geometric shape. Yes, this is a rectangle what he is talking about. So he has given the area inside. So it's nothing but how much he has given, 528 square meters. This is what he has given. Okay, now what are the two things he is talking about? He is talking about the length and the breadth. He is asking us to find what's the length and what's the breadth. These are the two unknowns. Okay, now as there are two unknowns to be figured out, I can say the first one is x and the other one is y. Cool. So we are having two unknowns. Fine. So as we are having two unknowns, don't get to addition. It's nothing but a linear equation under two variables. Now there are chances of getting back to a quadratic equation under one variable. How to get it? So as we all know, as there are two things to be figured it out, he has to give two relations. Right, he has to give two relations, relation one and relation two. Fine. What kind of relations he has given? Let's figure it out that. So the first relation, he is talking about the area. Right, what's area? What's the meaning of area? We know he has given about area, and we know area of a rectangle is nothing but length times breadth. Okay, what is the length we are taking? The length we are taking it as x, and the breadth we are taking it as y. That is x into y. That's the first thing. Means in the relation one, he is talking about the product. Product times, he is talking about the product. The relation what he has given is nothing but the product of two things. Product of two things. Fine, it's okay. That's the relation one. Now, what's the second relation he has given? If you check it out, the second relation is the length of a plot is one more. What's the meaning of more there? It's more is nothing but a plus. Okay, the first relation he has given in terms of product, that means times, and the second relation he has given in terms of plus, the sum or the plus, more. Okay, I think you got it. So here, right, the relation is in terms of product between the two unknowns. And here, in the second relation, he has given something like the sum or more, means something like plus. Right, do you think the product and the sum belongs to the same category of relations? Never. Right, so the product is a different category of relation. Always sum and a difference belongs to one category. Sum and a difference belongs to one category, whereas product belongs to one more category. Right, so whenever we are dealing with the product, obviously we get something like power of. Okay, so what to do now? It's very simple. So as we are having two relations of different categories, assume that it is not linear pair. As we are having two different relations, fix it as it is nothing but a quadratic equation under one variable. But we are having two variables here, x and y. Right. When it is x and y, how to remove one variable? It's using the relation to. The relation to, I can call it as helping relation or a relation used to eliminate one of the variable. Okay, which one do you like to eliminate? Any one of the variable. I like to eliminate y. I like to eliminate y. So how to eliminate y? So write y in terms of the x. Write y in terms of the x, basing upon the relation what he has given. Okay, right. After knowing the relation, plug the value of in the place wherever you get the value of y, in the place of that y, whatever we got in terms of x, plug it in that. Right. So what does it mean? We are eliminating y and we are getting the entire equation in terms of x, and as we are having product, obviously we get to the power 2. Why? Because in the place of y also we are plugging in x, of course, in terms of the relation what he has given. So x is already there and we are placing x in the place of y with some relations whatever he has given. Right. So as we are plugging one more x there, product of 2x is nothing but obviously x square, and y is eliminated. As it is x square, it is a quadratic equation under one variable. So this is a cool thing. So one relation is in terms of the product and one relation is in terms of class, right? More than. So use this relation as a helping relation and use the first relation as a relation to get a quadratic equation under the variable 1. So let's get back. Let's apply the logics what I have said to you in a verbal form, in a sentence form. So let's go for that one now. So guys, what he has given here. So the area of the rectangle is 528 square meters. So I have taken a rectangle and I'm calling it as rectangle ABCD in a cyclic order. Consider a rectangular plot ABCD. Cool. Now we have to consider the length of that and also the breadth of that. Okay, so we are taking the length and the breadth. So what is length and what is breadth? That those two are the unknowns. We have to call one as x and the other as y. Why? Because two things are unknown there. So which one should be taken as x and which one should be taken as y? Just wait for a second. So see here, right, area is 528 square meters. That is cool. What is the second relation what he has given? Let's stress on that. So what he has given, according to the problem, length is one more than its breadth. So before taking the x and y value there, just wait for a second and think on in this way. So length is one more than its breadth. What is compared to what? If you check it here, length is compared to the breadth. So always remember, to which it is considered, that you take it as x, and which is compared, that you take it as y. I repeat, to which comparison is done? Here length is compared to the breadth. Therefore take breadth as x. That makes your sum easier. No bigger issue than that. So length is one more than its breadth. Let's take the breadth as x. Then obviously the length will become y. That's a beautiful thing. Let me help you out for that. So let the breadth, what are the two breadths here? Breadth comma BC, or you can take BC or AD. Let's take it as x. That's what I'm saying. Let's take the breadth as x. If this is x, obviously this will be the x. Fine. Now, what is left over? The length. Now, as we have already taken it as x, now let us take this as y. Now, the length, what's the length? It's nothing but AB. Yes, it's nothing but AB. You can call AB or CD equals y. Hope you are able to understand. Okay, so we are taking the length of y, breadth as x and the length as y. Okay, it is given that area is 528 square meters. So what's the value he has given? Area is given it as 500 square centimeters. So area he has given it as 528 square meters. So what's the meaning of area? We all know area is nothing but length into breadth. So which implies length into breadth equals 528. Cool. Length into breadth is equal to 528. But what is length and what is breadth here? So length we are taking it as y. length we are taking it as y, and breadth we are taking it as x is equal to 528 square meters. This is the beautiful thing what we are supposed to weigh there. So see here, length into breadth, length I am taking it as y and breadth I am taking it as y, x, therefore y into x is equal to 528 square meters. Hold on there, pause a second, you call that one as equation 1, fine. Alright, so the relation or the equation which can be converted as the power of 2 is waiting there. Why? Because I said to you, powers, already product can pull a variable, can raise the power as 2. Here there are two variables, y and x, right? We are planning to eliminate y with the help of the helping relation. Alright, so replace y with x. Convert y in terms of x. How to? Let's see here. What he says? Length is one more than its breadth. So, write length, that is y, is. Till then, I'm fine. Right. Now, let's write the step in such a way. See here. One more than its breadth. More. As you all know, more means plus there. Okay, but while writing the step, write in the reverse order instead of moving in the straight. One more than its breadth. One means, as you all know, it's one. Breadth, we called it as x. Fine, right. One more than, twice its breadth. I think I messed up there. Twice its breadth. One more than, twice. You take it as twice, T-W-I-C-E. One more than, twice its breadth. Okay, one more than, twice its breadth. So, one more than, twice its breadth. So, I'm going in the reverse direction. One, fine. So, one is beginning here, but I'm writing in this direction. One more, fine. One more. Twice its breadth. What's the breadth here? Right, let me take it as breadth B only. So, which is nothing but one more twice its breadth. This is what the relation what we got. So, I'm going to replace y as 2x plus 1. Right. So, in the wherever I find y, I'm going to call it as 2x plus 1. I like to call it as equation 2. Fine. Okay, you got the relation. So here the substituting, right, y is equal to 2x plus 1, right, in equation 1. What's the first relation what we have, right? If you check it out here, the first relation is y into x equals 528 square meters. What's the value of y? Just now I said, wherever you find y, replace it with the 2x plus 1. So, I found y there. Of course, the x is waiting for us here. It's nothing but 528. I like to replace it with 2x plus 1. Okay, why? Because y into x is equal to 528. So, in the place of y, I'm replacing it with 2x plus 1. If you simplify that, it's nothing but 2x squared plus x. If you transpose it to other side, it's nothing but 528 equals 0. Okay, so now it's a beautiful term. We got a quadratic equation. Now what is left over? We are supposed to find the value of x. We can do in different methods. It might be splitting the middle term, or it might be formula method, whatever, right? So let's try it out in such a way. So let's factorize the equation what we got. So let's factorize the quadratic equation what we got. So these are the factors, 2x squared plus x minus 528. So while using the splitting the middle term method, we are supposed to multiply the 2 and the minus 528. If you multiply that, we are getting minus 1056. So let's factorize in such a way, you are not supposed to forget the number what is present over there. Here the number is nothing but 1. Right. We need to get a plus 1 there. We need to get. So how we are factorizing? Let's figure it out what are the factors. So I'm going with the 2s. If you check it out, 528 2s, right? 624, again 2s, again. Now I got it as 33. Now what I'm doing, I am multiplying all these stuffs here. Right, if we multiply all the stuff there, we are getting it as 32. All right, now 32, as we are having plus here, the bigger one I'm taking it as plus, and the smaller one I'm taking it as minus. So minus 32x plus 33x, we are getting it as plus 1x, which is there in the middle. I got it. I like to repeat, the 2 multiplied with 528, we are getting 1056. I'm factorizing that. Now I have multiplied all these 5s, right, the 2, 5, it's nothing but 32 and 33. If you multiply these two, we are getting back this. But, so as we are having plus sign, I have kept the plus to the bigger one and the smaller one with minus. If you sum them up, it's nothing but plus 1x, which is there in the middle. That is how it goes on. So let's work on that. So it's nothing but 2x squared, right, minus 32x plus 33x minus 528 equals 0. We are planning to factorize that. Now take common. If you take 2x as common, we are getting x plus 16. And if I take 33 as common, here x plus 16 equals 0. Now if you check it out, so x plus 16 times 2x plus 33 equals 0. Now if you apply 0 product to property, x plus 16 equals, right. I think I messed up here. So here we should get somewhere like minus, and here also we are getting it as minus here. Okay, so now we'll be getting minus here, right, x minus 16 equals 0, and the next one, 2x plus 33 equals 0, right? So x equals 16 and 2x equals minus 33, x is equal to minus 33 by 2. Okay, we got the value of x here, of course. We have rectified that. So if you check it out, one of the value is negative, the other value is positive. We know length can't be negative. Length can't be negative. Alright. So therefore, we are taking x as 16 centimeters. Alright. But the thing is, no need not only of x, we need the value of y also. If you check it out, the value of y, so we got, but y is equal to 2x plus 1. That is not what we got it. Right. Now let us plug in the value of y is equal to 2 into 16 plus 1. It's nothing but 32 plus 1, which is nothing but 33. So the value of y, we are getting it as 33. So we took the length is, therefore, length, comma, y is equal to 33 centimeters, and breadth, comma, x is equal to 16 centimeters. Fine. But the verification matters a lot. Verification matters a lot. What is the point we got it as? Verification. So what is said? Area is equal to 528 square meters, right? So area, we took it as x into y equals 528 square meters. Let's multiply 16 33s. Okay, now 16 into 33, obviously we are getting it as 500 square centimeters. So we can say it's verified there. So this is the calculation what we are working on. By this method, we are able to get the length of the rectangle and the breadth. And if you multiply, we are getting it as 528. So we can say the length is 33, which is the longest side, and the breadth is 16. In this channel, I have been placing both math and science videos.